Yo, what's up guys, back again with me Mato. Today's in the video I'm gonna show you how we create and manipulating these images using Adobe Photoshop to become a surreal t-shirt design like this. Meanwhile, you're gonna show all my entire process design from scratch to finish. I also divide my step process in several parts, so hope gonna be helpful for you to work with your own project. So without further ado, let's get started. Alright, I started the adjustment with skull head, and actually the concept was I'm gonna get rid of some part from the back of the skull and change it with meteor rock image that I had. And from that, I will add another images for elements to become my basic composition. By the way, I put this image link in the description below. And so, I'll just speed that part up and talk to you in a bit. In this process, I cut and adjust these images using several tools, such as the pen tools for an accurate cutting process. Then sometimes I also use the eraser tool to erase some small parts and transform all manually, and also using a warp tools to fit into different sections. And after that, I put it together into the design composition, and we're good to go to the next step, which is image treatments. Alright, in this part for image treatment, we will align or balance the color tones in each image so that they blend together. Usually, I'm gonna use gradient map, color balance, and levels so that it's my ultimate tool for balancing and do a color correction into my design. Adjustments level to increase contrast, and sometimes it can bring out more detail of my original images, and also for just a highlight and shadow transition. The gradient map is actually it's just for neutralize the original color of my image. It's a simple way if I wanted to change the dark and light color into whatever I want. So that's why I'm choosing to start with black and white color. It's pretty basic, I think, and also it can make more easier for me to adding a color or adjustment later. And color balance is to set a color ambience in each image. If I want to look more ambience for my design, like I want to get ambience color more bluish or yellowish or whatever I want, I set up all these things through these tools. And yes, so I'll just speed that part up because it's pretty boring actually. And yeah, I will talk to you in a bit. Next up is, I want to bring all these things more lively by adding shadows. I painting it using brush tool and spread it out, especially on the part of the image, which is cropped separately. There's no fancy way to be able doing that. Just set up your brush to saffron brush and play with flow value, and you can go to painting it into your design. So yeah, I'll speed it up this process. Stay tuned. I also painting of additional highlights to give me more aesthetic looks. A painting a highlight, it's pretty basic actually. I just using a brush tool and do the same steps as when I made or painting a shadows before. Or if you wanted to deep dive know about this process, I have made a full tutorial of it. You can check this out in the pop-up on the top right corner. So let's speed that part up and talk to you in a bit. Alright, for now I think it's good enough for my work, but I'm not sure that can be my perfect result. So now I did a bit of color adjustment again for optional touch maybe. I go to my camera filter and playing a bit with slider over there, and also adding a noise it a bit to increase the sharpness of my design. I'm also adding some of elements like crack overlay and combine it with my halftone texture. This is the things you should always experiment when you're designing, guys. Sometimes the result really shocks you. And lastly, I got the perfect adjustment to the design, and I'm really happy with it. Now I'm adding some of text in it and go to play the design to a short mockup and show you the final results. Alright guys, so that it's all for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. I'll be uploading another video later this week, so make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out. Follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes. Thanks for watching my video. See you on the next one. Peace.